we know that replies to text messages, replies to WhatsApp outbounds are getting dropped right now. This is a massive missed opportunity for our customers to engage with clients, because when the clients actually respond to a message, that's gold.
Hi, YouTube. The following interview took place August 6th, 2019 at Twilio's Signal Conference in San Francisco at Moscone West. It previously aired on our Signal TV broadcast over on twitch.tv/Twilio. In this interview, Andres Jaan Tack from Twilio sits down with Corey Weathers to talk about Twilio's new product, Twilio Conversations. I hope you enjoy this interview and live coding session.
Hey, what's up, friends? Super excited to be back with you. Listen, welcome back to Signal TV. It's your boy, Corey Hurricane Weathers, back here in the building. We're hanging out with Twilions again. We've been having some fun throughout the day. We've got more live interviews, more live demos set up for you. And so before I continue, I gotta say, welcome to the latest guest. This is Andres. Hi, Andres. Good to
Hi,
see
Corey.
You.
Hi, how are you doing?
I'm good. How about you?
Doing well. It's been a good day.
Has it been a good signal for you?
It's been a really good one. It was really great to be up on stage and actually launch this product. We've been working on it for an awfully long time.
Which is super exciting. We're here talking about conversations today, right?
Yep, that's the one.
Hey, we saw it here in the chat room. We had a ton of fun, And everyone was getting super excited about the possibility. Is there something special about conversations that stands out to you?
I think Jeff really nailed it, which is that the fact that we know that replies to text messages, replies to WhatsApp outbounds are getting dropped right now. This is a massive missed opportunity for our customers to engage with clients, because when the clients actually respond to a message, that's gold.
Yeah.
This is opt-in. This is the client actually expressing, I am already interested in what you have said, or I'm interested in engaging with your company. Help me do that.
Well, and I gotta tell you, it was the demo that was most compelling to me. I had a ton of fun watching the madness happen as Ricky was up there kicking off shoes and dropping down bags, and John was out there trying to moderate and referee and do a number of things.
Yep.
So shout out to you all for putting together such an amazing demo.
Yeah, we had a lot of fun putting that together. The point of that chaos on stage was to kind of show, and it got ridiculous, of course, at the end, how many people actually can be involved, how many employees you have that could be actually agents of your brand, really represent you to your customers and make a better experience.
It makes a ton of sense. And so I think it'd be good if we jumped into a demo. Are you ready to jump into a demo of conversations?
I think I can do that.
Now listen, as you're doing that, I'm gonna take a look here at the chat room. It looks like, someone's asked, are we getting another demo? Yes, we are. We're doing it right now. We're gonna have a ton of fun. Thank you all for hanging out with us. If you've got questions or things around the demo that you wanna see, you wanna hear, just drop a note in the chat room. We'll follow up with you when we can. That cool? Sweet, let's jump into it.
Great, let's get into it then. So, I love the Twilio CLI. I think it's a great tool, especially for this kind of situation.
Oh yeah, Twilio CLI. We love the CLI here as well. Yeah.
And the best feature of the Twilio CLI?
Autocomplete. Yeah, boy.
So creating conversation, this is super straightforward. You get a SID, like anything else. What I'm gonna go ahead and do is play with WhatsApp, which is one of the major channels that we support, and chat, which is the other, probably the most relevant for the brands.
Yeah.
When they communicate with customers, it's gonna be chat. So that's two participants that I'm gonna add here. Twilio,
okay.
API, conversations. Gonna create a chat participant. Over there, that's identity Tack, we'll call him.
Cool.
Actually, let's use a different name. Tackleton. Something.
Tackleton.
Tackleton. That's a good one. That'll also make it easier to find, because I've been using this demo instance quite a bit today.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. So the other one is, this is where we're going to add WhatsApp. Same conversation as before, but we're actually going to bind someone on the Twilio messaging platform. So we call that a messaging binding.
Oh.
Going to use my WhatsApp address here, which will make it easy for me to show you.
Oh, cool.
Conversation. We're also gonna bind a proxy address that I have set up. This is a Twilio phone number that I bought and I upgraded to support WhatsApp in the platform.
Oh my goodness. So wait, so we've got one person coming in through chat. We've got a second person coming in through WhatsApp using a Twilio phone number that's now been bumped up to be able to work in WhatsApp.
Yep. There's a whole approval process that we take you through. If you have the identity, you should use it, because WhatsApp is a tremendous channel.
That's awesome.
Great. So we're going to set that up. Got two members of this conversation. If I go ahead and break out my chat UI, I will log in as that user I mentioned, Tackleton. And there's that conversation that I created. Here's WhatsApp on the other side.
Yeah, I see WhatsApp on the right. Now, this chat UI, is this a local project you're running?
This chat UI, yeah, it's actually based on the quick start code that we published on the internet. So if you go to docs/conversations, you'll get a version of this.
And okay.
I think this UI is a little bit nicer, so it'll probably upgrade it further.
So that's super exciting. Twilio.com/docs/conversations. Mm-hmm. You can go grab a quick start there, friends. You can get started and see something super similar to help you engage with conversations. In addition to, we talked about this earlier, so I'm going to bring it back up. NPM, install, -g. Twilio CLI, Twilio-CLI. That's how you get the CLI going on your machine, right?
Absolutely.
So yeah, okay, cool. So we're back in our conversation.
Yep. This whole thing, by the way, based on the Twilio Programmable Chat SDK is completely unmodified. So I built this on an airplane trip at one point. You could build your own and customize it completely. But let's say I'm gonna be a customer of this personal shopping studio. Hey, I need some style.
Coming in through WhatsApp.
Can you help me out? Right? Write a WhatsApp message. That's going to land over here in chat.
Boom. Oh, look at that.
There it is. Automatically populated. You notice all I did was manipulate the REST API here. I declared who's talking with who. Didn't set up any ngrok, didn't set up any servers. You can, especially if you want to manipulate webhooks or do bots or anything like that. It's not necessary. To really set up the basics, REST API is all you need.
This is super interesting. Let me ask you a quick question. It's just come in through the chat window. How much do we know about this specific question? Is WhatsApp still in beta? Do you know?
WhatsApp is still in beta.
WhatsApp is still in beta as of today. No. Now, do we have any ideas? This is like a sensitive question,
You're
friends.
You're going to ask the hard question.
I'm going to ask the hard question. It's a super sensitive question. We have to ask it. I think I know what the answer is, but I'm going to see if Andres is going to tell us. Do we have any idea when that beta tag is going to come off of WhatsApp?
I'm awfully sorry. I don't have any idea that I can tell you.
Okay, friends. So we can't give you anything just yet. Keep the questions coming. Keep asking us. Keep us honest so we can keep asking for you. Let's hop back into our demo.
Let's hop back in. So, need some style tips. Can you help me out? Here I am. I'm the owner of this personal shopping atelier. I'm going to say, yep, absolutely. And since we're programmers here, we're not going to make it super complicated. Pants or shirt? Right? And guys on the other side going to say, I need pants. Make it super clear. So this is a call to action. We've been routing these messages text-based automatically back and forth. You can tell what type they are, and that's what I'm using to identify.
Oh, that is so cool.
Yep. But he needs pants. At this point, I can start describing the pants, but that really isn't going to take me all the way.
Mm-hmm.
I think it's going to be much better if I actually give them a picture of the pants I have in my inventory. So we're going to pop
that in. Wait, so this thing supports pictures as well?
Yep, media and text flow both back
and
forth
goodness.
Across all the time. And we support WhatsApp for this, we support MMS. SMS is obviously text only MMS.
But this is amazing. I mean, we're literally talking, and I love that we've got things like some of the context around when the message came in.
Mm-hmm.
Obviously, we have the date and the time. Obviously, this is all based on chat, so we have things around conversation history that go back, right?
Exactly. You can also examine that history in the REST API if you look at API conversations, messages, and list those out.
Oh my goodness. Watch the madness, friends. Here it comes.
All of those messages.
Wow.
Up there, and the source is there. The body, you can see if you output in JSON.
Oh my goodness.
Now, everything is here.
Look at how easy it is to see this information, friends.
Yeah, programmatically accessible. It has to be, because that's how you build the best experience.
I love that the CLI makes this super simple. And yet, at the same time, like, I can continue to come back to my app and do the things that I want to do inside of my app.
Yep. Once you build it up, the CLI is really a super useful tool for prototyping.
Absolutely.
It helps you cover that gap while you're still figuring out the experience that you want to create.
Yeah.
You can experiment with things. You can test things out without actually building the experience up front.
Well, we did get a question in the chat that asks, does conversation support GIFs? I think the answer is yes.
Yep. I'd have to look at the website to remind, but definitely JPEGs we support, GIFs we support. MP4s, I believe, that we support.
Mm-hmm.
I'd have to check. There's a fourth and a fifth, and I can never remember what they're.
And of course, folks are now starting to go down the rabbit hole, so we'll ask one more. What of ASCII art? You know, we love ASCII art. We developers, we're a little crazy. Does conversation support ASCII art, or specifically the CLI support ASCII art? Do you know?
Does the CLI support ASCII art? Well, ASCII art is text, so I would have to say yes.
We would hope so. Hey, friends, keep the questions coming. We're having a good time. I'm going to take a sip while Andres continues.
Great. Well, so this is the fullness of the demo that that I was going to show. I can show you maybe one more thing, which is that I mentioned there's a system of webhooks in the back to handle this. And this probably follows well from the keynote that we showed before.
Okay.
If we go to the console and look at the way this interacts with SMS messaging services, naturally it's going to make me log in.
Now, messaging services, for our friends who are not Twilio users, not as familiar with messaging services, what is it? How would you describe it?
Sure. Messaging services are a tool for controlling, for providing features on top of messaging. If you look at the list of things that we do here, this gets into interesting things. Suppose you add someone on MMS to this conversation that we just had. It's going to work out fine because MMS supports images. All routes back and forth perfectly just the same way.
Okay.
If, on the other hand, they're in Europe. At the time, Europe doesn't have great support for MMS. So depending on which country they are, whether we do it or not, we might have to fall back. And this is one of the things that you can control in these messaging services.
Oh, that's cool.
Yeah, so MMS converter is what that particular feature is about. So
yeah.
this is a function on messages that are going in and particularly going out of the Twilio messaging ecosystem.
Yeah.
That's what messaging services are for. Now, what we've done as part of the release of Twilio Conversations is we've changed the way that you set your inbound settings. The way you used to be able to do, you could set a webhook this way. The other thing that you can do, you can auto-create conversations from here.
Oh my goodness.
So any message that comes in to any of the numbers that are configured on these messaging services automatically creates a conversation. You can capture webhooks off the back of that, and that actually creates...
a two-sided conversation.
A two-sided conversation.
That's amazing.
Exactly, exactly. And you can handle all those webhooks over here, the conversations console that we now have released along with this.
So this is available in twilio.com/console.
Already
folks
today.
Log into their accounts, they'll see this today.
Absolutely,
cool.
Already today. And here you can set, we have post events, which is probably what people are familiar. There's a huge library of webhooks, very detailed information about what's happening with the conversation that you can opt into. You can capture after the fact is what we call a post webhook, or you can intercept and perhaps reject something. For example, if someone tries to join a conversation and you don't want them to be allowed, this
webhook,
you can intercept it, you can reject it with an HTTP 400 code, whatever you need, and they won't be allowed to join that conversation.
And so this is a webhook. If we select this event, it'll then route the incoming conversation to that webhook that we've got set up. We do everything we need to do, we log whatever we need to, and then at the end of it, they get rejected. How simple is this to configure, friends? I mean, this is super, super, super easy to me. I feel like I could just go have some fun with conversations today.
Yeah, that is the idea. We put a lot of effort into our documentation to get started. Webhooks, in particular, scoped webhooks, another feature. There's a lot of details, a lot of crannies, because we want to make sure that this works for bots. We want to make sure that it works with automation, that it helps with compliance matters and all of that.
Now, there was a scenario that was brought up in the chat room around this idea of how you could use the conversation history, the message history, and feed that into a machine learning app. Is that one of the scenarios that you all envisioned when you came up with the idea for conversations, you think?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, this is one of the critical things. It's a general principle in Twilio. It must be programmatically accessible.
Mm-hmm.
And if it isn't accessible in the form of a webhook or some form where it's like after the fact, you can collect all this information, run your analytics on it, run your machine learning algorithms on it, it wouldn't be as useful by far. So this has been a primary goal of ours.
Seems like it makes a lot of sense to me, right? From a scenario of just from analytics, you know, mm-hmm. say I'm in a, you know, call center scenario and there's conversations that are happening. We may not be using Flex.
Mm-hmm.
We may just be using conversations.
Yep.
You can then run analytics on the incoming conversations that are happening just based off of the webhook events.
Yeah, exactly. And it's interesting that you brought up Flex. It's one of our goals to make this part of Flex.
Is that right?
Forward. Yep.
That is amazing. So conversations combined with Flex feels like a real nice synergy because ideally, right, you're talking about multi-channel things, messaging-based things happening through just different interfaces, wherever people prefer.
Exactly, and it's exactly the kind of thing that happens in a contact center, which is that you have a participant, probably the customer, if it's an inbound contact, stays in place. But the agents behind it, you start with one, you move on to another. Maybe it's a long-running task that takes a couple of days to resolve.
That's right.
If they need more help in the middle of the night, you switch to a different agent. So this participant manipulation metaphor, Flex is one of the primary targets of it.
Oh my goodness, it makes a lot of sense.
Yeah,
this is phenomenal.
Yeah. But we didn't want to wait for it to be integrated with the Flex to release it because there's all sorts of other use cases. Personal shopping is my favorite because I have these lovely JPEGs that I can send.
Well, we love that. I got to ask the question. We talked about it earlier. We kind of glossed over it a little bit, but I want to bring it home, kind of nail the point. How can folks, if they want to go get started with conversations today, how can they do that?
Well, the best place to get started is going to be twilio.com/docs/conversations.
Twilio.com/docs/conversations. Yep. And look at this.
Yep.
This is beautiful.
Yeah, we spent a bunch of time on the quick start, making sure that it's addressable. One of the key things that we did, I don't think I'll be able to, is we used Code Sandbox to actually make this happen.
Oh, really?
Yeah. So Code Sandbox, this is a live code editor. I'm not super familiar with a whole bunch of them, but the idea is that without downloading a GitHub repository, setting things up locally, making sure you have the right stuff installed, Cold Sandbox has all of that set up for you.
That's right.
You can
right.
do a lot of this work and get started in the browser.
That's amazing.
Yeah, I think it really short circuits the experience.
Yeah, I love this. And so I would say this seems like an easy way to get started. I do want to answer a question that came up in the chat because I want to make sure that we just hit the point home. It says, could we kind of sort messages by chat ID or something like that? And I think, and you tell me if I'm wrong, because Conversations is built on top of chat, there is a structure or a bit of a history in place such that you know when a message came in chronologically or in what specific order.
Yep, and the ordering is something that chat has supported for a long time. So this is one of the reasons we really leaned hard on the chat infrastructure. This stuff scales really well, and it has a lot of these basic features already into it. So I listed the messages that we had already. You notice this parameter in here, index.
That's right.
That starts from 0, counts to 1, counts to 2. This is the way that you totally order messages.
All of the messages.
All of the messages, unless you know something else. You're always welcome to use the date created. Instead, you can use something about the message. We're going to work to add the flexible JSON attributes here as well.
Nice.
So if there's something about the message, for instance, starring a message, that's going to be the tool to do it. Each individual message can have their own things.
That is amazing, Andres. I got to tell you, I'm super excited. I see this, and I do want to go do some conversations in Twilio Quest. Is there a mission?
That's a great question. I'm afraid I didn't check.
Oh, okay, good. So we can find out. We'll all go have some fun.
That sounds like a good quest for us.
But listen, friends, we've had Andres now for the last 15 or so minutes. We're going to let him go. Thanks again, Andres, for hanging out with us and showing us some more stuff about Conversations.
Of course. Thanks for having me.
And we'll see you all soon. It's your boy, Corey Hurricane Weathers. I'm out of here.
If you like what you saw in this interview, please consider heading over to twitch.tv/Twilio and giving us a follow there. We'll have more content like this there very soon.